Hello, this is the RPG Check. Welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. Switching back to Ivo again. As soon as you can go through that fireplace. She's probably going to end up in some other fireplace. I mean, I'm pretty sure it was Owl, Worm, Rat, I believe. If they have any further insights.
Hello, Sloth. Blout.
Ah, Princess Iva.
They won't give that
Thanks
to me.
For the chat.
You were like a beak.
Yeah.
As far as I know, you just need to throw a bit of this powder into the fireplace and then get in it.
And think about where you have to go.
Right then. Bit of powder into the fire.
Here goes nothing.
Am I thinking of the right symbols?
Owl, worm, and rat. Well, what happens if I go eagle, mole, and penguin?
Eagle, mole, and penguin. Eagle, mole, and penguin. No. A strange house with a red-haired family. The father's just talking about something he calls a witch?
Huh. Okay, he's a red-headed stepchild. That's why I choose these other ones, to see these interesting responses. Lion, polar bear, and caterpillar, which I know is wrong.
Lion, polar bear, and caterpillar. Lion, polar bear, and caterpillar. No, a fireplace in a cozy living room. There was a hairy fellow standing by the fireplace with me who was constantly calling for someone called Harry.
Eh. Okay, Harry Potter reference. It's most probably Sirius Black. Owl, worm, and rat. Ta-da! Yay!
Those appear to have been the right symbols.
Yes.
I think we've been discovered.
Oh, goody.
Hello? I'm not going to harm you. Wilbur told me of this library.
Wilbur? Is he well?
He disappeared suddenly.
He had to go underground. Mm. Supernatural forces now have the say in the school.
Ach, we know that. We looked through a crack in the door and saw that terrible woman and her daughter.
No, he literally went underground.
They didn't exactly look like intellectuals.
If the Van Buren's discover this library, then you'll have to prepare yourself for a future of being colored in with crayons.
Ooh, that'll do it. They'll help you now.
Don't worry, we won't let it come to that. However, to prevent it, I have to get into the staff room.
Then go. Courage stands at the beginning of a task and luck at the end.
Hmm. Is that how it goes? Let's look at the fire.
Why is there a fire here? Did you light it?
No, that was Wilbur.
But that must have been days ago.
We thought it was strange too. Hey, Wilbur must be a mighty spellcaster if a fire he conjured up burns for so long.
A mighty spell maybe, but from Wilbur? Unlikely.
He had the Elder Wand. Let's look at the bear fur.
I've never been a big fan of hanging dead animals on the wall or laying them out on the floor. I'd much prefer them running around in a wood.
Yeah, they're our friends. Okay, so we got the desk and we got these books.
It's a good thing the library can disguise itself.
Ooh, sorry, it moved like that?
Riots and revolutions are all too often accompanied by burning books.
Hmm. Talk to them.
Excuse me?
How can we help you, oh friend of the friend of books?
I need to find out how one casts a spell on ghosts.
Can I cast a spell on a ghost?
I don't know. Are you some kind of ghost whisperer?
Not at all.
No?
So why ask me when you know you can't?
No. Can you tell me how to cast a spell on a ghost?
Ah, well that's completely different. Mm. We have several good books on grammar here.
Look, what? Thank you, but I'm really just interested in casting a spell at the moment.
I know all about that.
Excellent. So how do I do it? To be precise, I need to trap or render the ghost incapable of movement.
Right.
I think what you need is a magic circle.
Hmm.
That's a symbol that you draw onto the ground. Ghosts are incapable of leaving this kind of circle, at least not for a while.
It's just gonna let me do that?
Hmm, sounds good. Do these symbols get drawn with blood or salt or something of that sort?
Actually, most people use chalk. But I'm sure you could use blood as well, if that's what you're really into. It's not really important how the symbols get onto the ground. It's a square with a circle over it that has to have exactly the same surface area. And a right-angled triangle must be placed into the circle.
Sounds like something out of a mathematics book.
Ha! Mathematics. This is about science, not some kind of hocus pocus.
Oh, okay.
Oi! I heard that!
So what was that about the magic circle again?
What was that about the magic circle again? One has to draw a symbol under the ghost.
Won't matter one iota whether you draw it or carve it into stone or whatever. Just get it onto the ground under the ghost in some shape or form. As long as the ghost finds itself over a square with a circle and a triangle, it will be trapped.
Excellent.
Okay, got it.
So maybe we can do that with the light. We can shine light down in that kind of pattern and trap it that way. Because it's sure not going to let us walk up to and do it with chalk.
I have to go.
Bonne chance. What's that wonderful saying? Better to be an ignorant traveler than to be wise and to sit at home.
I don't know that one.
Wait a minute. She is traveling and we are sitting here.
That's right.
Excuse me?
How can we help you, oh friend of the friend of books?
Nothing new.
I have to go.
Come back soon.
Just look at the desk.
The workplace of a bookbinder, I think. I can practically still smell the troll snot. Ugh.
Mm. We can look up here.
An impressive library. No wonder the medicine book was so disappointed with the library in the elf burrow.
Hmm.
Right then, very carefully.
Right, because you can't hear me.
Hasn't noticed anything. Now, must be really quiet. Hasn't noticed me yet. As long as I'm quiet, the situation's unlikely to change.
Unless he just turns around and looks this way.
He hasn't noticed. Our idiot guard can't hear anything anymore. I better get the Archmage out of the staff room as quickly as possible. Our idiot... According to Wilbur, the door's locked, and it'll only open when the headmaster says the code. According to Wilbur...
Okay. We gotta use the slate.
After you, headmaster.
469-41.
Have a good evening, headmaster, madam.
Looked easier than when Wilbur did it.
Well, my little one, have they been treating you well? I'll get you out of here. I just have to take care of something first. I can't leave Buttercup behind. She may be a creation of the little Van Buren, but she's my pink-coloured, love-hearty hippogriff girl.
She did create her? Huh.
She can come with me as soon as I've finished here. She can wait in the town. She can come with...
A strange being. Look at that fireplace.
Very unlikely that a fire will be burning in that fireplace anytime soon. I wonder if all these transformations can be reversed when Wilbur finds a way of destroying the magic wand.
That would be cool. Junk. Look at the junk.
I must admit, there was probably a time when I would have thought these sort of toys very exciting. But I was probably only 80 or 90 years old then.
Only 80 or 90 years old. We can't fit through there.
Lucky the council leader hasn't noticed that I've cleared the entrance to the rat hole. She wouldn't appreciate the rats having access to her headquarters.
Did we clear that?
That's Wilbur's realm down there. I'm dealing with everything in the town. This division of labor's worked very well up to now.
The jar with the archmage inside.
The jar's been fastened to the cupboard with heavy and presumably magic chains.
Oh, it's also fastened to the cupboard.
I wonder if... Aha! Archmage Alistair!
Huh.
Are you well?
We've got him. Was that easy?
I can't understand you. Blink once for yes and twice for no. What does no blinks mean? Hang on. Can frogs even blink? I think we'll need to sort this out later. I'm getting you out of here.
Yeah, frogs can blink. Blink!
Goodness knows if the Archmage is still in there. The frog looks like a frog, and behaves like one, too.
Num-nums, eat! You know, I click at it once, and she turns towards it. Without doing anything. I have to click twice, I guess.
Lots of papers, feather quills. This is interesting.
Is it?
A signet ring with the seal of the council leader. It's used to make laws and decrees official and identifiable. That means that until the council leader discovers it, I can pretty much pass any new law that I want.
Sweet. Did we take it?
Right then, a new law.
Oh, that's what we want now to get Blout's amulet. Prerequisite for a marriage is love, nothing else.
Two adult humans, dwarves, elves, or any other beings capable of rational thought are allowed to marry whomsoever they please, and in any combination. Only prerequisite, love. No one will be forced to marry a pompous ass just because he's a rich prince and mother thinks that I'm getting a bit long in the tooth.
Well, nothing personal, though.
Perhaps not the best phrase lore of all time, but what the heck.
I took it. Oh, we've got a decree. Only marry for love law.
This law decrees that two people may marry if they love each other, irrelevant of who they are, and no one can be forced into a loveless marriage.
Awesome.
That should really all go without saying.
Yeah, it should, but, you know. You turn the other way for
right then, a new law.
Smoking dried leaves for medicinal purposes is no longer forbidden. Oh, 420 time.
By order of the council leader, whosoever wishes to inhale the smoke of dried plants may do so for medical reasons. Furthermore, they are permitted to do so in order to write bad poetry or talk utter nonsense. That's for Arbor, should he ever come to town.
Cool.
A law allowing the smoking of dried leaves for medicinal reasons. I have a distinct feeling that this one may prove a hit with some people.
Aye, verily.
Right then, a new law.
Pregnant elves must be treated with the utmost respect.
By order of the council leader, with immediate effect, all pregnant elves must be treated with the greatest respect by everyone. In particular, it is forbidden to call them fat, to poke fun at them, or to try and kill them with an axe.
Hear, hear.
Anyone breaking this law will be banished from the town. That makes it law.
So all these law law papers now.
A law decreeing that every pregnant elf should be treated with respect. One is not, for instance, allowed to chop their head off with an axe.
All right.
Right then, a new law.
What if I do this instead?
It's no use just passing laws all the time. Every now and again, one has to do a bit of work.
Just wanted to see what she would say.
Right then, a new law.
Finally, the wearing of a protective amulet will be punishable by being made cute.
By order of the council leader, with immediate effect, the wearing of magic protective amulets is forbidden.
Forbidden.
Well, I don't actually need a reason, just because. Whoever is caught with such an amulet will be punished with severe cuteness for at least 6 months.
That's for Blout.
Right, with seal and everything. This law decrees that from now on the wearing of magical amulets is forbidden. Anyone infringing this law will be severely punished.
By becoming all cute.
Making new laws is fun, but as they won't be enforced, I'd really better concentrate on doing the more serious stuff. She can come with me as soon as I've finished here.
Well, we are finished here.
Okay, Buttercup. You have to be really quiet now. No. Quiet.
Yeah, it's not quiet.
Okay, let's go.
Anyone got a muffle? Oh, guess we got out.
I said quietly, Buttercup. No, the troll was not your friend. He was trying to kill us. No, I'm pretty sure that he didn't just want to play when he started hacking at us. Be that as it may, Archmage Alistair is safe now. As soon as Wilbur has rescued Remy and knows how we can destroy the wand, we'll need to leave as quickly as possible. Morning's approaching, and in all probability, this'll be the day that we see the return of a very, very frustrated council leader.
Yeah, no kidding.
Ah, she's not exactly the most impressive of companions now, is she? However, up to now, I've only ever had Cheep Cheep at my side.
Spelled it right.
Reminds me, where is he?
They spelled it right now.
As soon as Wilbur has rescued Remy and we've got a plan together, then my noble flying steed will carry me off to new adventures.
Is that how it goes?
As soon as...
Alright, let's go... Just for fun, what if I go back in here?
Nope, the troll would kick up a real stink if he saw me. I better go in via the back entrance through the library.
I don't need to do that now. Hey, I bypassed a... Ah. I can't talk to Wilbur anymore. We can put up our new decree.
If I do my job right, then soon I'm going to be an enemy of the state. And looking at this regime, I'd regard that as an honor. No one on the road is treating me disrespectfully. There must be a better place for this law.
What about this one?
I'll keep this law for Mother. I sincerely doubt she'll be impressed by it, but at least she'll get to see it.
And this?
I could put up the law. So if everyone starts to smoke herbs and the council leader catches them,
herbs,
then they won't be able to throw the book at them. I don't want to be responsible for destroying the careers of a few hard-working young people.
But that would help them. What about this? I thought we'd show this to Blout.
Most people have fled town or hiding in their houses. Hardly anyone will see this lore if I put it up here. I must be able to put it somewhere better.
Yeah, into Blout's hands. Alright, let's go do that. Oh, there they are. Right. Wrong order. What did I think? Okay, never mind.
I'll let them have some time on. They've got... Hi, you.
Oh, hello.
Yet they say hello every time, and she says hello to them every time anyway.
Hello, Sloth. Blout.
Hello. Stop playing with your boob.
Ah, Princess Iva.
Got stuck. Do you know I can transform the Archmage back?
Have you got any idea how one can change back something the little Van Buren transformed?
Because they would have done it
if
already.
If I knew that, I'd have turned our lovely inn back to normal ages ago.
Are you expiring?
No.
No.
I fear, though, Blout, that you're currently committing a crime.
I'm sorry to have to say this, but you are a criminal, Blout.
Blout, not criminal.
How did I know I was going to say
Blout
that?
Blout stands here like good little ogre and sells strange things.
You're wearing an amulet, and that's against the law.
What'd it say?
By order of the Merchant Council leader, and with immediate effect, the wearing of magical protection is forbidden because... Well, I don't need any reason, just because. Whoever is caught with such an item is to be punished with severe cutification for a minimum of 6 months.
Cutification?
Huh? No! Blout don't want to be little girl with pigtails. Got to escape, love.
Well, perhaps you can ask the friendly law enforcement officer to turn a blind eye.
Or perhaps...
Who's eye blind?
What he means, Blout, is if you are really sorry about this and you can see you've made a mistake, then maybe the daughter of the council leader doesn't need to hear about it.
Sorry! Very sorry! Very wrong!
I will, however, need to confiscate the amulet so that you won't be tempted to wear it in secret.
Confiscate. Take away.
Oh, sure. You don't tell little girl, right? Blout want to stay Blout.
I'll keep it for myself.
Righto. Remember, ignorance of the law is not immunity from the law.
I don't know what there is to talk about at the moment.
Okay, I'm not sure why we'd need to go back to the library, so...
The amulet shows the magic circle symbol. If a ghost stands in such a circle, it can't leave it. I hope.
Okay, so we just gotta get this to Wilbur.
Wilbur?
Why is she whispering?
No reply. Doesn't appear to be there.
Oh, crap. Of course, because he's down there. We gotta get him back up. Wilbur, gotta move on. His characters are a little lethargic. Now, how would he know to go there, but...
Timmy? Yeah?
I have found Remy, Timmy.
I'm still looking for your uncle.
Yeah, that's not what I chose.
Don't worry. I'm sure you'll find him soon. Yeah, sure. If he knew his uncle was caught in a trap and badly injured, he'd be sick with worry.
Okay,
or
you're
worse,
right.
He could march straight to the temple himself.
Oh.
I've got to get back.
You can do it.
I'll get Remy out of that terrible temple. I owe it to him and Timmy.
Right. If we can tell her that we found him.
Hi, Ethel.
Jump.
Well, ooh, you always have this habit of creeping up on me.
I found Remy. He's not very well.
I found Remy. He's injured. Do you have anything like a healing potion?
I'll prepare one at once. Will take a while if it's to be a strong one.
Okay.
Okay. Please do your best. And do you by any chance know anything about ghosts?
Oh, superstitious nonsense.
No.
That isn't quite true. There's one down there.
Oh, temperature changes, fog, drops, no ghosts.
It talks.
Look, there's a ghost down there and it's taken Remy prisoner.
Hallucination, suggestion, not real. Get Remy here, quick!
If you say so, you look after the healing potion then. I'll deal with the hallucination. I'll see what I can do for Remy.
Yes, quick, quick!
She gets startled every time I speak to her.
Alright, let's go talk to Ivo. I suppose I could start the conversation from either side, but I have got the Archmage.
I've saved Archmage Alistair.
Sort of.
Or the frog that we think is Archmage Alistair.
Kraken! Is he alright?
Kraken?
Yeah, he's okay. Got a few bumps and bruises. But it wasn't because I dropped him a couple of times fighting the troll together with a hippogriff or anything like that.
Ivo?
Hmm?
Did you just say you rolled a hippogriff into battle against a troll?
The Archmage is safe, okay?
I've got an amulet for you.
I've got an amulet for you. It shows the magic circle symbol.
Which is it magic?
He wouldn't know anything about it.
Not in the slightest. But it shows the symbol you have to draw on the ground underneath the ghost to trap him.
Okay. Got it. Thanks.
That's all for now.
See you later.
Over and out.
Once I draw the symbol on the ground under the ghost, he'll be spellbound. Only, how can I do it?
All I have to do is put it in front of the mirror.
I was in the temple and there's a terrifying ghost.
That's great. That gives it a little pep.
Yeah.
A little pep? My friend is dying.
And you have only a short amount of time to save him. This is exciting, isn't it?
This is all just a game to you, isn't it? But rats are dying here. If something happens to Remy because you wouldn't help me, then... Ah! Bugger this for a box of frogs. I don't have time to waste on you gods.
Or
I have problems to solve.
What's the matter with him?
He's dramatic. Oh, what happened to his voice there?
I've had enough of gods. I have to take care of Remy.
Well, that's not how I said it before.
I've had enough.
That is funny. Okay.
I've had enough of.
All right, let's go. Put the amulet onto the mirror.
If I put the medallion on the mirror, then the shadow might...
Haha. Awesome.
It works! Yes! The ghost can't leave the magic circle. I have to get to Remy, quick. Remy!
Good idea. Using the magic circle, Wilbur.
Thank you.
But it won't hold him off for long.
Okay, but we gotta get out of here quick.
No.
No?
It's too late, Wilbur.
What?
The trap is probably the only thing holding me together.
Oh, no. We can help you up there. There are healing potions, magic. Something is bound to work.
It's not too late. A good healing potion or a powerful healing spell and you're back on your feet.
I don't have much time. Let's not waste it with impossible dreaming. I've only just found out what is going on with the wand.
If only I'd come sooner.
If only I'd got here earlier. If only I'd got to the island more quickly.
You're here. That's what counts.
Those gods have delayed us.
My death won't be in vain. And I have a friend by my side. In my final hour.
No.
I thank you for that.
We gotta save him. What have you found out about the magic wand?
What about the wand?
There were two brothers. Powerful sorcerers. They amassed much wealth and power. With the help of dark knowledge, they searched and found this temple. One of them went insane and left town. The other was killed by my grandfather.
Remy!
Shortly before the brother's death, he transferred all of his power to a wand. That power would only be unleashed if a blood descendant held the wand in their hands.
He's a blood descendant? Then the evil ghost is the ghost of the sorcerer that was murdered here?
And one of the creators still guards his machine as a ghost.
No. My grandfather must have encountered the sorcerer by coincidence. He realized what the sorcerer's plan was and defeated him. He gave his life and never left the temple again.
You mean...
He guards the wand. Didn't want it to find its way into the hands of the descendant of the sorcerer.
So Wilbur's the descendant.
This is evil, Wilbur. It changes people. The wall between our world and the dungeon dimension is particularly thin here. The influence of the Nameless One is strong. I think my grandfather has forgotten who he was. He only exists to protect the wand.
I still don't understand. Why is my wand suddenly so powerful? I understand completely, because he is the ancestor of the famous gnome mage from back then that we've heard of a few times.
You found the wand and gave it to me, but I don't understand.
Wilbur, in everyday life, the sorcerers were merchants. Their surname was Van Buren.
Oh no, I got it wrong.
Sybil married Montgomery Van Buren, the sorcerer's youngest son. Her daughter, Chantal, has a Van Buren blood flowing through her veins.
Ah.
The first time the wand acted strangely was in the classroom. It must have sensed Chantal.
And when Chantal got her hands on it, she received all her grandfather's secret powers, but not his knowledge.
How can the wand be destroyed?
How can we destroy the wand?
It's explained in the second brother's book of spells. He spent his final years mentally deranged in the dark woods.
Dark woods.
And the one brother came up with a way to break the other's power if it ever became necessary.
Yes. You must find the book and destroy the wand, Wilbur.
Uh-oh.
Go now, my friend.
Remy!
The resistance needs a leader. And I know of no greater fighter for good than you.
No.
Give this to Timmy. Please, look after him.
Oh my God, no. Oh. But he was the coolest rat ever. Sad. Oh. Thought he was gonna cross the barrier there.
happened? Where's Uncle Remy? I'm so sorry. No. But...
So sad.
You said you'd bring him back.
I tried.
I would have at least grabbed the trap, maybe a resurrection spell or something.
All set to go? They're waiting down by the gate.
Who?
All right. And Timmy?
Esther and Nate are taking care of him.
Are we going to the Darkwood?
You really are quite sure?
Yes. Remy said the key to the Wand's destruction lies in the Dark Woods. And his death shall not be in vain.
No, it shan't be. I just don't know if we should split up. We're a good team together.
We'll make faster progress if I focus on the Wand and you on the Archmage.
You look after the Archmage, I'll search for the book. Van Buren can't chase us both.
You're right. She'll be beside herself when she notices that the Archmage is gone.
Any idea how to bring him back?
Nope.
Not the slightest, but I know how to find out.
How?
An oracle told me. I'll have to help a friend and will not know what to do. I must then find a flying pirate island and on it a building without corners.
Huh.
Then that's your path. Come on, Gulliver. Let's go and see what Timmy's up to.
Yep. Good luck. Look after yourself.
And we should put as much distance between us and Seastone before the old witch realizes what's happened.
Come on then, Buttercup.
Oh, you blinked.
We're trying to find a flying pirate island. That's where we'll find the answers. Too many questions.
Some kind of circular tower on it, no corners.
Cheep, here you are at last. We're looking for a flying island. Try to keep up this time.
He's mute. Remy!
It's quite fascinating how you can get other people to work for you, if you know the right buttons to press.
He got influenced by the evil.
Your services are no longer needed.
You're going to bring the Nameless One back to this world!
Nonsense. Only an idiot or a lunatic would try something like that.
Huh.
And I am neither.
Monkus. Brother.
It was a long flight, and it looks like I'm getting heavier and heavier to boot. Have a rest, but stay close by. The oracle said that it was to be found in a building without corners on a flying island.
Well, we found it.
Tugator's the only flying island that I know. Let's hope we find a few answers here.
Not only that, we're going to find Nate and Critter here. Thanks for watching, everyone. A little bit extra long episode. See you next time in a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.